Okay, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nora Mirabika Ahmadazri and my matric number is 1201056. So today I'll be going to present the evaluation of the built environment. Today I'm going to evaluate my house, which is located in Serini Melawati Residen. So I'm currently staying at Serini Melawati Residen. It is located in Taman Melawati, Kuala Lumpur. As you can see, the building is separated into two towers, which is Tower 1 and Tower 2, which they are separated with the public facilities at the center. The tower designed into two 38 story lifestyle towers. Okay, next, we have the site plan here. So we can see around the area. So this is the Serini Melawati. Around there, they have some education a place for education and religion purpose and a pet healthcare. Okay, then we have the resident. The apartment has four types of houses. As for me, I'm staying at the type A1, and then for the type B, C, and D, the difference is the space is more bigger and bigger from the space type A. And then this is the floor plan of my house. So the entrance, you can see the entrance at there. And when we go into the entrance, we can see the kitchen first. From the kitchen, we can see the dining and living room. And at the other side, we have a utility room and master bedroom. And the bathroom is just only one at the center of the room. Okay, so the relationship between men to creator. So we have five principles here, which is respect for knowledge and conscience of the creator, justice, compassion, trustworthy, and credibility, and unity. Okay, first let's go to the principle of respect for knowledge and conscience of the creator. So first, at the site plan, at the area of the apartment, it contains education and religious purpose in healthcare place. So we can see at the area, let's see at the red circle that I have shown in the picture. This one is the education for the education like school. We have Little Genius here, Little Genius, and then we have Sekolah Menengah Usahawan Al-Amin. And then for the religious purpose or for Islam, for the Muslim, they can go to the Masjid Ilama Al-Hidayah here. And then there is a pet healthcare, which is Clinic Haiwan Mesra here. So, and then my second point is each house provides a study table and utility room. So, you can see at the picture at the right, the red circle show the table in the utility room. So, each house has their own study table. So, student or worker can do their work at there, as it encouraged in Islam to get their A-in more. And then, the number three, no specific area to perform prayer. So in this in my house, there is no specific area to perform prayer. But then we are using the utility and master bedroom space as the used to perform the prayer. And sometimes we are using the living room to perform a jemaah prayer. And then we go to the principle of justice. So first, facilities like public swimming pool, the ground, gym, and store area are located at the center of the tower. So it is located at the center of the tower, and then the resident will go to the center, which show the equal between the tower one and the tower two. So that's why they are doing at the center. For the gym and the public swimming pool, they are not separated by gender, which is it is not encouraged in Islam to gather between men and women. And then the second point is apartment have their own type of space. So I want to show the justice here is where the apartment they have their own choices. So people can choose according to their affordness and comply the people needs that can comply the people that will live in the needs that people will live in. And next, compassion. Compassion is my first point is apartment contain large window for residents to have awareness of Allah's creation. So in this apartment, there will be a large window. At that, from the window, we can see the scenery of the Taman Melawati town, and we can see from the picture here. We can see from there. We can see a mountain, a sky, and the houses. And so from there, we can it shows the awareness of Allah's creation. It shows the powerful of Allah's creation. And then the second point is the design of the building not reflecting the religious and cultural heritage. So from this building, it's according to the modern contemporary design. So it's not showing any religious pattern. And then from the trustworthy and credibility, comply with people's need and pass the minimum standard of family of three, kitchen, bathroom, and bedroom. So in this case, I'm staying with my three family members, which is my father and my sister. In this case, the house is complete, which it contains kitchen, bathroom, and bedroom, so that we can have we can cook, we can go bath, and we can have sleep. But then for the master bedroom, my father is only using the master bedroom, and the single bed here, me and my sister is not using it. But then we're sleeping together at the living room. And so but if the family having single daughter or single son, we can use the single bedroom, and the mother and father can use the master bedroom. Then for the unity, for the principle of unity, we have a living room because it's for Jemaah prayer. So from this, in this house, it's not too big, the space is not too big, where the living room is the only choice for us to perform Jemaah prayer. So in this hadis di surah Al-Hujurat ayat 10 yang bermaksud sesungguhnya orang-orang mukmin itu bersaudara kerana itu damaikanlah antara kedua saudaramu yang berselisih dan bertakwa kepada Allah agar kamu dapat rahmat. So in this case, we are doing the Jemaah prayer to show the unity, to praise the Allah's we go to the relationship between men to environment, which is we have three, with cleanliness and beauty, preservation of the environment and sustainable natural resources, and economic and effective use of resources. So next, we have cleanliness and healthy principle. So first, the kibla not toward the toilet, which is good. So as you can see in the picture, the kibla is actually is right here, and then the bathroom is right here, so it's not facing the toilet. And then air conditioner provided for cooling system. So in this case, the air conditioner is like for the student or workers to have study, and the air conditioner is provided, it's give the comfortable. And then number three, the public area of the apartment always cleaned by the workers. The apartment is regularly, the workers regularly having the duty by cleaning the environment of the apartment. Okay, and then second next principle is preservation of the environment and sustainable material. So first, in this apartment, they are using a lot of used greenery on the building. So as you can see in the picture, we have here the pool, the swimming pool, the store area, and the lobby. They put a lot of green plants and greenery. And then the second one is the apartment was fully built with concrete. So they are not, in this case, they are not using timber. They are using timber material only used for outdoor and louvers. So in this case, they are using concrete. That is because they are built a high-rise building. So to get the building more sturdy, they are using concrete. But then the concrete will release the amount of carbon in the air. So a lot of amount of carbon in the air. So give the air pollution to the environment. Okay, next, economic and effective use of the resource. The building is using immense this is the masonry building. So it can stand in a long period of time if there's no issue on construction of the building. So it can provide safety to the resident and also environment. Okay, next, we go to the relationship between men to men. We have six principles here, which is respecting privacy and division of space, the value of encouraging interaction and acquaintance, peace and security, respecting the rights of the individual, cooperation, sensitivity, and mutual respect and consultation. Okay, next, respecting privacy and division of space. First, we have the point is the sliding door provided at each room. So the sliding door is provided at each room, which is at the master bedroom and the utility room. And then the space is just equivalent for 3 family members only. We could just And then the third one is kitchen at the front of the room, which gives more privacy, as you can see in the picture. And then the value of encouraging interaction and acquaintance. So first, the living room and dining room provided for family members together. So for example, like the family members are watching TV together, and then family members are having the meal together at the dining table. They can the relationship between the family members become more close. And then the second is public facilities provided for residents to have social interaction. As you can see in the picture below, they have some square area at the public facilities. So people, when they gather there, they can have some social interaction. They can talk. Okay, next, we have peace and security. The apartment, they are provide security, CCTV, and crisis system. So for the respecting the right of the individual, each of the house expectedly has some gap in their own space, and it divided by equally. It's mean it's not like every space is the same, but it's equally divided because of how the people afford the house. And then the cooperation, sensitivity, and maturism. In this case, there are a lot of races staying at the apartment, so all races can perform their prayer without problem in their houses, as long as they not interrupting and any other religions and making kids like a racist. And then consult every resident can give feedbacks to have good development of the apartment. Now, from the relationship men to creator, we can see that there are just three principles about the relationship between men to creator. And then men to environment, they have only one principle, is not abide to the relationship men to environment. And then men to men, five principles about the relationship men to men. To conclude this, I think it's the house is not to abide the rububiyah, Mulkiyah and Ubudiyah in Al-Fatiha. It is because of it may lack of something. It's like, for example, from the principle cleanliness and duty, it's like some of the people may throw the rubbish in the trash bin, and some of the people also it's not aware of the effect and they neglect it. Also another example, let's see for the unity. It's like our family members may have some work to do, so they cannot perform the Jumu'ah prayer together, so they need to pray individually. I think that's all. Thank you for